So this is the GUI of Scratch animation. We have to perform by using the software called as Scratch. So the right side window is the output window, and this cartoon is called as sprite. And this sprite is movable. We can move this sprite wherever you want. Okay. So this is the sprite window, and this is, we call it as output window. So the next in the middle window, this white screen in the middle is called as coding window, where we will drag and drop the code, or whatever the code for animation will be, it will appear here. Okay. In the left side, there are three tabs: code, costumes, and sound. So these are three tabs, and there are some controls. So see here, the first control is motion control. Now in this motion control, you have some following code, like move 10 steps. Now if I want this sprite to move 10 steps, I will just drag this and put it into the coding window. Students, remember here we do not have to write any code. The code is already there, just we have to drag and drop. So I want this sprite to move 10 steps. So what I did, I just dragged this code in the coding window. So when I click on this move, see, my sprite will move now. When I click on this move, see, the sprite is moving. So the sprite will move 10 steps ahead. Okay. So just by clicking on the code will run. So this is the move 10 steps. Now if I want the sprite, next tab I have is turn 15 degree. So turn 15 degree, right? So when I click on this, see, my sprite is getting turned 15 degree. Okay. So if you want this sprite to turn 90 degree, so what you will be doing is just right here, instead of 50, write 90. Now see, it will rotate at 90 degree. See. Okay. This is rotating at 90 degree. So this is my see, the way you are writing the degree, it will turn. Okay. So if you don't want this code, then again keep it back. Similarly, this next code is rotate 15 degree in the anti-clockwise. So when I click here, see, my sprite is getting turned 15 degree. So similarly, there are some go to random position. Okay, so when I click here, go to random position. See, it is going, the sprite is going to any position. See, when I click here, sprite is moving to any position. That means go to random position, okay? Similarly, go to X and Y. Now, if I see here, my sprite is now at minus 26 and 86. If you see here X and Y coordinates in the right side, so this X and Y means the sprite window position. So suppose my sprite is now at say 141 and minus 33. But here in the code I have written minus 26 and 86. So when I click on go to X and Y, see, my sprite will go to that position where there is minus 26 and 86 as X and Y. So if I see, if I have taken this sprite somewhere here, when I click on go to, then it will go to the previous position because I have given the coordinates of X and Y axis. So this is my code. Okay. Then next we have glide. So this glide means what? It will slide. Okay. Glide is nothing but slide in animation. So I will show you. See, this sprite is going to the random position. Okay, it glide for 1 second. See, okay, it is going to the random position because we have chosen here random position. You can choose your mouse pointer also. So when I click on glide, so we need to. See here, it will go somewhere here. Okay, so this is what the glide is. This is how the very these controls are. Okay, then we have looks. Second tab is looks. Now in looks, the first is say hello for 2 seconds. Now when I click here, see this sprite will say hello for 2 seconds. See? See, the sprite is saying hello for 2 seconds. Okay, so if you want to say hi, then just instead of this hello, write hi and then click. Okay, the sprite is saying hi. You can change this time also. Instead of 2, you can write 1 second or 3 seconds. Okay, so whatever you want, you can write here. And whatever you want to say, you can write in this white block. Okay, so when I click on say, see, it is showing hi. Okay. Only you want to say hello continuously, then it will display hello. And not for 2 seconds, it will display continuous hello only. Okay. So these are some controls. One by one we will see. It is not possible to show everything, but one by one we will see in the coding. Okay. Next we have sound. So see. Now I want this sprite to say meow. So when I click on this play sound, see it is showing the sound of this meow. Okay. So this is how we will add the sound to the sprite. You can change the sounds also. There are multiple sounds. If you go in the sound section, you will get that. Okay. There are multiple sounds. Next we have is event window. Event means what? When I click it somewhere, this is called as event. Action means it is an event. When you are clicking somewhere, or when you are moving something, or when you want to broadcast it. So that comes under event section. So see here, this is one of the code. When green flag clicked, means what? See here, this is a green flag. So when I click on this green flag, my sprite will start working. So this option is when, see here, if suppose I took this here, okay, when I want to attach this code to this, when I clicked green. So when I click this green, my sound got played. Because we do not need to click every time on the code. So instead of code, what we will do, we will attach the code to this green flag. So when I click on this green flag, my sprite will run. See. Okay, we are just playing the sound. So if you want to play a sound and then say hello for 2 seconds, then just drag the code and attach it below the sound. And again, click on green flag. The sprite says meow for 2 seconds. Sorry, the sprite says meow and say hello for 2 seconds. See. And if you don't want this code, then you can remove it also. Okay. So this is one example of simple animation. Then after event, you have controls. So these controls are repeat forever, wait. Wait for 1 second. Now I want after saying meow, the sprite should wait for some second, that is for 1 second, and then he should say hello. So what I did, I just dragged the set code of wait and I had attached to the coding in between play sound and say hello. Okay. Now when I click here, see the sprite now waits for a second and then he says hello. First, the sound got played, then it wait for a second, and then say it says hello. See here. Okay, got it? So now next we have, if I want this to repeat for multiple times. So if I want this to repeat for multiple times, then this is the repeat code. You have to just attach in between the codes wherever you want. Okay, so I had just attached this repeat code. And I want to repeat it for 10 times, but instead of 10, I will write 2 times. Okay. So when I run this, see. It got repeated 2 times. Okay. It is repeating 2 times. So once you click on this red option, it will get stopped. Else it will repeat, go on repeating. Okay. Now if you want to play this sound only, okay, say hello only one time. Okay, suppose I want to say hello only one time and I want to play this sound repeatedly. So what I did, I just dragged the code and put outside this repeat box. Okay, outside the repeat code, I put the code say hello. Now see when I click on green flag. See. It said hello and the sound got played two times. See again. So this is the use of repeat. And if you want this for forever, means go on continuously, then there is a tag called as forever. Just take this and drag wherever you want. Okay. And now I don't want this repeat tag, so I will just remove it and I will attach this forever tag. So forever means what? It will continuously go on saying hello. Okay. Sorry, meow. So this is the forever tag. So similarly, there are multiple tags. The next control is sensing control. So in sensing, you can change the color, you can put a distance, you can ask something. Now see here, I will just show you. Now I want it to ask what is your name. Okay. Now I want Sprite should ask what is your name. So what did he did is first he says hello, then he play a sound. And then he asks, what is your name? So when he asks, what is your name? There will be an input box here. You are seeing the input box and you can type the input. So here I am typing my name, Shervali, Shervali. So when I type my name and when I hit enter, it will display, it will vanishes. But I want to say that Sprite, that hi Shervali, I want this. So what I will be doing, so whatever the name this sprite will insert, that value should be stored into some variable. So now I will store that value into a variable. So now I will take a variable. So see in the variable block, if you go into a variable, there is an option called as make a variable. Okay, so I will click here, make a variable. I will name that variable as A. So that whatever the data user will enter, that will stored into this A variable. And I want this for only this sprite. So I click the option for this sprite only, and then I will click on OK. So see the whatever the data will be, now it will be going into an A block. Now I want this to insert. Okay, I want insert code. So if you go into the controls. So what I did, I just taken this show variable, show A, and I have attached to below here. Okay. So when I run this, see now. What is your name? It's asking. So it will go into a variable A. Okay. So this is the one example of Sprite. Now, if I want to change the background, suppose if I want to change the background, see in the right side of the lower window, here it is choose a backdrop. So click on that. There are multiple backdrops. You can choose any backdrop you want. So let's take one backdrop. See, I have taken this backdrop. You can move this sprite wherever you want. And then I will click this run. Okay, so this is simple animation I've created for a second. So now let's take another example. If you want to take other example, then just you need to add a sprite. Okay, so just go into file, take new. So the new window got appeared. Now what I want is, I want this sprite to glide. So let me show you. So as this is one of our code, see here this sprite is going to the position which is mentioned into X and Y. Okay, and remember the backdrop I have chosen, that is an XY grid. So I have already shown you how to choose a backdrop. To go into this choose backdrop, and then see here I have taken this XY grid as my backdrop. Okay, so if you want to stop this, we will stop this with the help of red button. And as I had used this forever tag, this sprite will move forever. Okay, until you make it stop. So I will stop this sprite now. Yeah, I've stopped this sprite. Now let's see how we use a glide option. So I will take this glide and I will attach here. Okay, at the end of this code. Now see how it glides. I run this. See, it is sliding it down. Okay, as I had written the code, glide to X11 and Y3. So X11 and Y3 is somewhere here, so that the sprite is gliding it down. So this is the simple animation we have created. So I hope everyone had understood this scratch animation. You can create any animation with this help of software. You have to only drag the code and then make it the changes. You don't need to write any coding here. So just drag and drop options are available. And there are multiple codes here. So this is the scratch animation, simple scratch animation.